dead. Straight out of Compton, crazy motherfucker named Ice Cube. From the gang called niggas with attitudes. When I'm called off, I got a sawed off. Squeeze a trigger and bodies are hauled off. You too, boy, if you fuck with me. The police are gonna have to come and get me. Off your ass, that's how I'm going out. For the punk motherfuckers that's showing out. Niggas start to mumble, they wanna rumble. Mix them and cook them in a pot like gumbo. Going off on the motherfucker like that.
I sincerely apologize for that really silly intro, but welcome to Mothman Jones Movie Reviews. I'm your host, John Maffio, and today's featured movie is Straight Outta Compton. It's the story about one of the most influential hip-hop groups of all time, Dudes with Attitudes, including Ice Cube, Dr. Dre, and the late, rest in peace, Eazy-E, also MC Ren and DJ Yella. But this movie is directed by F. Gary Gray. It stars O'Shea Jackson, Ice Cube's son, Jason Mitchell, Corey Hawkins, and Paul Giamatti. Because you have to have Paul Giamatti in these movies. It's basically about the rise of this group and how they became one of the most successful hip-hop groups ever. I got really excited for this film the moment it got greenlit and placed into production. But then I forgot about it for a while until very recently. And then I got hyped for it again. And now that this movie's apparently doing as successful as it is, we should get a Tupac biopic. Right now. It's been in development forever. Get it going. Get the ball rolling. But going into this movie, I was excited because it looked like a lot of fun, but it also looked very interesting and also informative on the hip-hop group and what it inspired for years to come. Right off the bat, I have to say that Straight Outta Compton was a really well-directed piece of filmmaking that drove me insane with emotions in many ways. It gave me happiness, it gave me laughter, but it also gave me drama and tragedy. Things that I wasn't really expecting to see executed as well as they were in this movie. It starts off with a really fast-paced motion going, like the movie really starts off with a bang. Literally, a bang. Then we're thrown right into the young lives of these now successful people before they got their fame and fortune, and you don't get a solid taste of what happens throughout. But the movie takes the most important pieces of these people's lives for the most part and puts them in a way that's very organic, natural, and entertaining to watch. The first half of the movie is very energetic, very fun, very exciting. It has drama, it has emotion, but it's also very uplifting and very like, yeah, very inspiring. The second half, however, gets a little muddled, mundane, and driven with sad emotions. But it didn't take away from my experience because I enjoyed all the emotion still because it had been earned from the first half of the movie. And there are a couple scenes in the movie towards the end where I actually cried a lot. And I didn't expect to. Even though I know what happens with certain people in certain situations. Straight Outta Compton, the movie about NWA, brings the feels. All the main acting players in this game do a magnificent job. Ice Cube's son. Not to mention the fact that he looks just like his father and he's playing his father in this movie. How freaking weird is that? How, like, being on set, acting like your father, does that not, like, make you, like, want to go insane? I don't know. But this guy did a great job portraying his father and doing his father proud. He showed the charisma, the attitude, and he showed that he could not give a single F. Because Ice Cube back in the day was just a beast. Corey Hawkins plays Dr. Dre, and I think he's the character that you are pulled into the most and you relate to the most because he's the one who's really got the most relatability going on, and he does a good job of showing you how he becomes the leader that he is today. And Jason Mitchell, who plays the late Eazy-E, does the most with his acting as far as like emotions are concerned. He brings a lot to the table. Without giving anything away, I think his character arc from beginning to end is very strong and poignant, and the actor did the person a lot of justice. His transition from reluctance to ambition flows naturally. Like a lot of autobiographies and movies that are based on real life people who have either passed away or just had very successful lives, a lot of things are dramatized to make the film all the more dramatic because film is about drama. You want drama in your films. So if everything was exactly how it was in real life, it would be a little monotonous and boring. But I think they did, as I said before, take the most important pieces, for the most part, from these people and their group from the late 80s to early 90s, and they really made a really, really solid movie. It is probably, in my opinion, one of the most entertaining biopics Hollywood has produced in a long time, and I feel like I could watch this movie over and over again, not just because it's entertaining, but the soundtrack, which I finally have to get to, is superb. Not only do they play all the greatest NWA songs, which, as they should in an NWA movie, but they also played other tracks that you may recognize from the late 80s and early 90s, even the 70s, like these really cool disco songs, some really awesome instrumentally resound music that really gets you going. For example, they brought in Wu-Tang's Cream, so they represent the Staten Island for a brief moment in this movie, and for that, they get automatic props. I also want to mention that there are a lot of cameos, and by cameos, I mean cameos of rappers played by actors who were around at the time and were very prevalent. Now, the Biggie Smalls movie that came out a few years ago, which is not nearly as good as this movie, not nearly as good at all, in my opinion, even though it does have redeeming values, did the same thing. Anthony Mackie, who plays Falcon in the Captain America movies now, played Tupac. But the actors they got for certain rappers were so nailed down to a T that I thought maybe they used CGI. Because the actors they got to portray certain rappers looked so dead on that it was freaking me out. But to wrap things up, I have to say, truly and honestly, Straight Outta Compton may be one of my favorite movies of 2015, and definitely one of my favorite movies of the summer. I had a lot of fun with it. It's entertaining, it's informative, but most importantly, it brings the drama and the feels, and it made me very emotional towards the end. And it's a movie that I recommend to anybody who wants to find out more about this hip-hop group or anything. I feel like anybody could watch this movie despite all the aggressive and excessive language, so on and so forth, the gratuitous nudity, which there is a little gratuitous nudity, but it's all going towards a good purpose and showing what this rap group did for society as a whole, and it did a whole lot. I flat out love this movie, but I'm not going to give it the 5 out of 5 rating because it does have some flaws. The pacing does get a little weird towards the end, and certain character arcs could have been more fleshed out. The movie is a 4 out of 5. It's a darn good movie. But I'm telling you right now, I loved it, and if it's on a top 10 list at the end of the year, I would not be surprised. Definitely check this out as soon as possible. It's not making $60 million this weekend for no reason. It's fantastic. But now I want to know from you, OGs, what did you think of Straight Outta Compton? Let me know what you thought in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and subscribe to my channel. Also, check out my Facebook and Twitter down there in the info box. I'm John Maffio, aka Mothman Jones, and I'll see you, mother effers, next time.